G'day friends, welcome to Creative X. My name is Brad Hussey and I'm a web designer from Canada. Our guest today, however, is not from Canada. Although from the Commonwealth, he is in fact from Down Under. His name is Adrian and he runs a YouTube channel called Codex Community. So you're going to want to check that out, but not yet, because I was able to convince him to stay up super late to have a few minute chat with me about no code versus code. All right, let's go. Hey Adrian, how's it going, man?
Yeah, it's going well. It's a little bit late here in Western Australia, but you know, that's time zones for you,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, totally. I appreciate it. It's pretty early for me. I mean, it's the beginning of my workday, but still, like, it's I know we're like right at the end of your day here, so I appreciate you staying up to hang out and chat for a little bit.
I'm a developer. That's what we do. We just stay up till the late night, right?
That's true. It's like that's the hour of the coder. Speaking of that, no code, as we call it now, so building sites without code, using all the cool tools and automations and drag and drop things that we have accessible to us today. Do you think that no code is replacing the front end developer, or what are your thoughts on that?
So I think it's almost like the next step of how you build a website. In the past, we had like, you would build out the website with just code. Then we'd maybe get Bootstrap or something on top that we would still use the code, but we'd have something on top to make it a little bit easier. Then we'd have importing modules or React that would make it simpler again. And now we've taken the step further where we've got something taking care of all that and we're just dragging and dropping things in. And in the background, we still have all that manual code. We still have all those plugins and everything. And it's basically just removing the difficulties of having to do that yourself and giving you a nice GUI interface to do what you would normally have to write out all the code with, right?
My thoughts here is that I'm curious. I don't think that no code is replacing the developer at all, because who builds no code tools? Obviously developers. But I wonder if that intermediary role of like someone who kind of communicates design and development, like, are they being replaced, or are they actually the ones who, let's say, if I go back in time, the designer would give me a design, I would build that in EditorX, and then the developer would take, you know, any complexities, hooking in an API, using JavaScript within the Velo developer tools. Maybe that's how that would work, rather than me like HTML, CSS, PHP, like maybe it wouldn't be that.
Nothing ever really replaces the developer. Not, you know, tools like we've had in the past that started playing around with drag and drop, not AI, nothing like that. At the end of the day, you still have one mindset of work that is done by designers, where they're graphically creating interfaces, and one type of work for the creation of the website, which is often the developers. I think that the change now is that some of the difficulties of creating those sites are just now simplified. So like the developers can drag and drop these things in, but still have the tools in the back where they can add in like Velo or script or whatever they want, or APIs to hook in that data. And at some level, you're always gonna need that. I've seen that even backend services now are starting to have no code tools where you can basically no code your database and your API and then hook it up to your no code front end. And like, it essentially means that at most levels, if you know what you're doing, then you can build a whole ecosystem out. But that mindset that you need to do it is still a developer mindset.
Interesting. I would agree. It's like the developer is less the tools. Like if we think as a developer, I am defined by the programming languages that I write, I think that would be the wrong way of seeing it, because what happens when inevitably that programming language is deprecated or it's just no longer used? Yeah. Like,
let me give you an analogy. Yeah. Imagine that a developer is like someone doing gardening. And first you're using your hands and you're like digging through. And then suddenly you find you have a shovel and you get better at gardening. And then eventually you get this monstrous machine that does everything for you. But at the end of the day, you're still gardening and that's what you enjoy doing.
Yes, exactly. And then if you have more automated tools, or let's say self-watering systems that uses solar energy, like, is it replacing
with automation? Exactly. Yeah, that's, you're still doing the garden at the end of the day. You just have more tools available to do the stuff that you enjoy doing.
Yes, it's more of that It's more of that higher level role and mentality. You have to think through the process in order to design and program the machines to do it for you. So, you know, as no code is here, it's not like, okay, move aside, developer, let the designer do your job. It's like, no, you still need to think through the logic of a workflow or what, you know, if this, then that. Essentially, if you can distill a developer down to a few words, it's if this, then that, right?
So true, so true. If I've done many nested if-thens before.
Yeah. Yes.
Very true.
And that's the magic of it. It's like you capture a condition and you go, if this happens, then do this. And then you can infinitely, you know, regress and keep going into all these different conditional statements. And that's essentially, you know, building sites with no code doesn't mean there's no logic and no sophistication. It you know, it still requires that developer mentality. So what sort of opportunities do you think no code is giving to, let's say, because we know what it's giving to designers and creatives and agencies, they get power at their fingertips now without coding. But what is it doing to, say, augment or empower or help developers? In what ways do you think no code actually helps developers?
So for me, I see like a few different things that it's done for me and with people I've worked with. The very first is the fact that what used to take us 2 or 3 weeks to do manually with code, we can basically get the same results in 2 or 3 days. But that means that we have that additional amount of time to work on really cool features that might happen in the back end or the front end. It just gives us more time to like build out something really cool. I think that's been the major change that I've seen in most situations. But the add-on change to that is where you would spend a lot of that time doing grunt work, just coding, coding, coding. You no code it and you have time now to research, hey, can I pull in like some cool animation here? How can I do that? Can I pull in some cool scripting like functionality or pull in some APIs to do something different? Like, you have less things to learn before. If you wanted to learn it, you would have to learn all the code for every single plugin and feature that you want to implement. Now, some of those features are taken care of. And because you have more time, if there's other features you want to implement, you can just look them up as well.
Is it inevitable that no code always just ends up leading to code? So for example, you can no code your startup idea. Sure, that's nice, but eventually, if you actually want to be a serious startup or company or agency, you're going to have to code it. So your prototype idea to validate it, thank you, that's really nice and cute, but now it's time to play in the big leagues and actually code this up. Is it always inevitable that happens?
What I'm seeing is actually the opposite. Mm. You're starting to see all these things like microservices and APIs and whatnot. And slowly you're seeing better documentation, better code, simplified code, and even GUI interfaces for it, to the point where now you have tools where if it's image detection or if it's AI, it's simply like a click, drag, and connect to your own website or application. So now you can start building applications without knowing how to do artificial intelligence because you're just plugging into another system. Now you can build a website without knowing all the stuff that you might need to for code because you're just pulling that for no code. And you drag and drop these two things together and you've got an AI generated, you know, you've got a website that can do AI components, right? Mm-hmm. But there are so many more, like you're seeing more and more of these industries adopting a simplified process to integrate their systems. And it's gonna get to the point where, yes, we might not have to know every nitty gritty thing. We could build an entire startup or business or idea just connecting these tools together. And I think that's where drag and drop is actually heading. But at the same level, the people who might be building those independent businesses like the AI, they still need to know, obviously, the Python or whatever it is that they're building those in. And you get to decide like whether you want to go hardcore into Python or if you enjoy building the website. So if you like building SaaSes, then each one will have a different paradigm.
So you think that no code is, do you think that like agencies and companies are going to be actually, or maybe they already are, looking to hire roles that are literally no coders?
I'm definitely seeing that. Like even at my own workplace, what used to take, you know, as I mentioned, 2 or 3 weeks to do, we're now getting just our designer to do it in a week or two. And then when he runs out of time, he can easily hand it off to a developer like me and I can finish it up, or I can just do the whole thing while he moves on to making a logo or something like that.
Mm.
So it actually lets the designers and developers collaborate a lot more on projects too, I found, where before they just had no idea what I was doing.
Ah, that's really cool. It's like it, yeah, it's more collaborative in nature too, where you can kind of work on that rather than, you know, you in isolation, you design, you're in Photoshop or Illustrator or now Sketch and Figma, and then code and then some backend wizardry. Now it's like, we can actually collaborate on this whole process in the same, and if we're speaking of Editor X, with the collaboration tools, like we could literally as a team be building this thing out. I can be doing the creative.
Exactly. Like I can help you make some yellow fonts and some pink backgrounds, or I can leave that part up to you to pick the colors and fonts, and I can help you build what you've, you know, demonstrated as the style sheet, right? So maybe I can't do all the design stuff, but I can create the stuff based on pre-made assets, which always also helps.
I did a site. I built a site in Editor X, and from the designer standpoint, I thought, okay, what's going to happen is I'm going to have these two components, the side-by-side column, toggle back and forth as you go down. So every second element is going to switch. So, you know, I know how to do that in CSS, but I needed to use JavaScript. And so my JavaScript is pretty bad. Like I knew it was going to be clunky. So I consulted with an Editor X developer who understood Velo and was really good at it. And basically, he just wrote the code for me and I put it in Velo, and then boom, like the site's exactly how I envisioned it creatively.
Yeah, like I think at some level there'll be better drag and drop tools for performing those actions. And at the same time, I think that maybe then the interactions that we can create are then going to be more complex when we get developers to build them.
What would you say are the pros and cons, like general pros and cons of no code? And then the general pros and cons of code when trying to achieve the same outcome. So like we're saying, we're trying to build websites. Maybe you're an agency and you're trying to build websites for clients. What do you think would be like the pros and cons of going the no code route and using something that doesn't require any code?
I'd say the very first is similar to, I guess, the early days of the web, where it's still early days, right? No code is early days. So you shouldn't expect that you'll get everything. And this is where like, coding gives you the ability to be like Edward Scissorhands. You basically have every tool at your disposal. You can cut things up any way you want. And eventually, no code will be like that for everything. But at the same time, you have to understand that right now, like there is some structure that you need to place and you need to follow some paradigms if you want good results. Like if you want responsive designs, you need to put things in containers or whatnot. You can't just like throw things at a page and expect good results. But at the same time, that methodology, I think, is something that a lot of developers understand because they're used to putting like divs inside of containers, inside of columns, inside of rows. So it's just understanding there is a bit of a mindset shift from one to the other. But also understanding that like it will grow and improve over time. I think the biggest part for me is the fact that like I can give people access to like an Editor X website and have them sit with me and update stuff. Whereas before, like having to jump into the backend code and sort of try and update that looked like a nightmare. It was a nightmare and it gave, you know, clients no confidence that they could do it themselves.
And like, you'd have that part being like, don't touch this or you'll break everything. And they're like, I don't want to do that.
Oh, for sure. But not to say that like that still can't happen on no coding tools. Like at the end of the day, I'm still going to be like, don't touch anything. Just double click on the font and edit it. Don't move it. Because yeah, it's always going to be one of those things, right?
Don't do this. You know, you keep the clients in check. So then what do you think would be pros and cons of the code route? You know, I know you kind of touched on them there in between that first part, but saying like, no, I'm just doing code, doing the same thing.
So the code part is like the pros is that you are, like I said, Edward Scissorhands. You can cut things up any way you want. But as soon as you do that, any mistake can like break it. If you're not careful, like you might not even notice that it's broken on one browser as opposed to another. Whereas like, no coding cool sort of like it just takes care of that in the background. You don't have to worry about it. It's all good. I think that's one of the things I really like, because I know my CSS sometimes was terrible in terms of like browser compatibility. And then again, like one of the benefits is, yes, I can animate anything any way I want to the nth degree. Like I can have some parallax, fade in, sliding gizmo. But like at the end of the day, do I ever actually do that? Do I ever implement these things? And if I did, like it would just look so startling to a user that like, yeah, most people don't. It's just like a smooth fade in, and that's all you really need at the end of the day. So you really have to weigh up what you're actually doing most times for websites, and most times like all that extra features that you might have if you're just doing it manually isn't really necessary.
I don't think coders have anything to worry about, and no coders are on like this, the precipice of like, I think the internet and the way we build for it is changing for the better, and it's making it more democratized and accessible, and it creates lots of opportunity for developers to improve and refine and create these sorts of tools and this methodology. And for designers and creatives and people who aren't technical, it gives them the opportunity to create amazing solutions for the world. So before we go, let people know where can they, if they want to know more about your work and what you're doing, where can we send them?
Yeah, so I've got my own channel that I'm running up called Codex Community. And realistically, it's more about like the real kind of work that developers often do that's slowly changing. So I'm doing stuff on right now a pricing calculator, which is really cool. It's actually trying to figure out how much you should charge for a website, but I'm also building that using no coding tools and coding tools and combining them all together. So you guys get to learn at the same time as seeing how it's implemented. And hopefully it's a valuable like tool that you can use yourself if you're doing freelancing or anything really. So yeah, you can check that out. I'm sure it'll be in the description or something, right?
You bet. Adrian, thank you so much. Really appreciate it. We'll make sure to link up your channel and that pricing calculator. I love pricing. So that's going to be all linked up there. Check out Adrian's work. And we really appreciate you coming on today, man.
Thanks, man. All right. See you later.
Cheers. Thanks for watching, friends. If you like this video, make sure to tap that like button, because that tells YouTube to spread the love and get this channel in front of more and more wonderful people like you. The more the merrier, I say. Subscribe to Adrian's channel, the Codex Community. We're going to link that up here on the screen down below. And until next time, we'll see you in another video. Hooray!